Liquid nitrogen has become a popular, eye-catching additive for preparing cocktails and frozen snacks like ice cream. But the trendy treats are often served at the side of questionable safety practices. Take, for example, this vendor that a c&en reporter spotted making liquid nitrogen ice cream without any protective equipment. Chemists know liquid nitrogen can be hazardous when mishandled, but when handled properly, it can deliver creamy and delicious ice cream safely. We'll show you how and give you the scoop on why ice cream is different from other dangerous sub-zero snacks. We asked American University's Matt Hartings, a c&en advisor and author of the book Chemistry in Your Kitchen, to show us how to make delicious liquid nitrogen ice cream while minimizing risk. So why make ice cream with liquid nitrogen? What's the benefit?
So whenever you make ice cream, one of the things you're looking for is really creamy ice cream, right? That's what makes ice cream good. And so there are two ways to do that, right? One is you can add chemical additives to slow down or to help with the freezing process. And the other way is to freeze your ice cream really, really, really fast.
Okay.
If you freeze your ice cream really fast, you make small ice crystals, right? The bigger the ice crystals are, the grittier the ice cream will be. So we want to make really small ice crystals.
With a temperature of around minus 196 degrees Celsius, liquid nitrogen freezes ice cream fast, yielding tiny ice crystals and smooth ice cream. But it can also cause frostbite and eye damage with even brief direct contact.
I think when a lot of people make liquid nitrogen ice cream, you get used to it, right? There, you can control it, but we always try to look to take care of those instances that you can't control.
Safe handling starts with using a proper storage vessel, such as this vacuum-insulated Dewar designed to hold extremely cold liquids. Safety experts recommend storing nitrogen that'll be used to make ice cream in clean containers and working with a high purity grade of liquid nitrogen to avoid contaminants. Another risk to keep in mind is that evaporated nitrogen can displace oxygen in the air and lead to asphyxiation. So make sure you're making ice cream in a ventilated space to ensure the gas can disperse. You should also consider the amount of liquid nitrogen you'll need to make your particular batch of ice cream.
So if I have a big container of liquid nitrogen like this, I need to be better equipped to handle that any mishaps with that large container, as opposed to if I have a small container like this, where I have minimized my overall risk from having a small amount of liquid nitrogen.
Matt starts by pouring ice cream base, a mixture of milk, cream, sugar, and flavorings, into the mixing bowl.
One of the things that also helps make ice cream creamy is air bubbles, the presence of air bubbles. So really fast mixing also helps to make a creamy ice cream. Okay, so here we go.
After a few moments of churning, Matt slowly pours in liquid nitrogen from the large Dewar. He wears a face shield to protect his face and eyes from splashing liquid nitrogen. He also protects his body by wearing an apron, long sleeves, and an insulated glove. OSHA, the Occupational Safety and Health Administration, notes that the glove should be loose-fitting and easily removable in case liquid nitrogen splashes onto it. OSHA's standards for personal protective equipment are the same, regardless of whether workers are in an ice cream shop or in a lab. When working with a smaller amount of liquid nitrogen, less protective safety equipment is required, although Matt still protects his hand with the insulated glove. Matt continues to add small amounts of liquid nitrogen to the mixture until it reaches the desired consistency.
And that's just about right. So the other precaution that you always need to take whenever you're serving any sort of food that uses liquid nitrogen or dry ice or anything like that, you need to make sure that all of that has evaporated or sublimated by the time that you serve it. You don't want to serve anything that is too cold.
That was the problem with the popular treat Dragon's Breath this summer. Vendors would submerge things like cereal in liquid nitrogen and serve it immediately to customers. Although this enabled people to breathe puffs of liquid nitrogen smoke, it also led to severe injuries, according to a recent advisory issued by the US FDA. The extremely cold morsels can cause burns inside the mouth and esophagus. The agency urged consumers to avoid these types of foods prepared at point of sale with liquid nitrogen. But like Matt, the agency told us that as long as the nitrogen has evaporated completely and the food is no longer at an extremely low temperature, liquid nitrogen frozen treats can be enjoyed safely. Speaking of which,
there he is, nice, fluffy, smooth ice cream.
That's very creamy.
Satisfied customer.
For more sweet ice cream chemistry, check out Emma Hiolski's What's That Stuff article all about the stuff that goes into your favorite scoop. Do you have a favorite kitchen chemistry technique? Let us know in the comments.